Howard Colby Ives was a Unitarian minister in New York who became a Baha'i after encounters with ʻAbdu'l-Bahá. Howard was also a smoker. When ʻAbdu'l-Bahá visited New York, Howard was not in the best of health, having some lung difficulties. In his own words, "I was not at all well that summer. A relapse was threatening a return of a condition which had necessitated a major operation the year before. My nervous condition made me consider breaking the habit of smoking, which had been with me all my adult life. I had always prided myself on the ability to break the habit at any time. In fact, I had several times cut off the use of tobacco for a period of many months. But this time, to my surprise and chagrin, I found my nerves and will in such a condition that after 2 or 3 days, the craving became too much for me. Finally, it occurred to me to ask the assistance of ʻAbdu'l-Bahá. I had read his beautiful tablet beginning, "O ye pure friends of God," in which he glorified personal cleanliness and urged the avoidance of anything tending towards habits of self-indulgence. "Surely," I said to myself, "he will tell me how to overcome this habit." So, when I next saw him, I told him all about it. It was like a child confessing to his mother, and my voice trailed away to embarrassed silence after only the fewest of words. But he understood, indeed much better than I did. Again, I was conscious of an embracing, understanding love as he regarded me. After a moment, he asked quietly how much I smoked. I told him. He said he did not think that would hurt me, that the men in the Orient smoked all the time, that their hair and beards and clothing became saturated and often very offensive. But that I did not do this, and at my age and having been accustomed to it for so many years, he did not think that I should let it trouble me at all. His gentle eyes and smile seemed to hold a twinkle that recalled my impression of his enjoyment of a divine joke. I was somewhat overwhelmed. Not a dissertation on the evils of habit, not an explanation of the bad effects on health, not a summoning of my willpower to overcome desire. Rather, a charter of freedom did he present to me. I did not understand, but it was a great relief, for somehow I knew that this was wise advice. So immediately that inner conflict was stilled, and I enjoyed my smoke with no smitings of conscience. But 2 days after this conversation, I found the desire for tobacco had entirely left me, and I did not smoke again for 7 years. From this encounter, Howard concluded the power of love to bring true freedom, freedom from desires of self, from the habits of lower nature, from the fetters of this world, through an all-embracing love that ʻAbdu'l-Bahá evinced, he freed Howard from a focus on self, and through showering each other with loving kindness, we can accompany each other to free ourselves from the bondage of the animal promptings that weigh us down. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, please like and subscribe.